So, good morning, everyone. My name is Eric Fischer. I work for the City of Nantes and Nantes Métropole as project manager, and I lead the migration to LibreOffice. I also have a side job as a freelance change management consultant. A brief word about the context about the City of Nantes and Nantes Métropole. Well, in case you don't know, Nantes is here. It's the sixth city in France. We have about 5,000 users, computer users, in the organization. We have finished our migration last April. Nantes is no stranger to open source. The IT department runs a lot of open source on servers, mostly Linux servers. And also we have our former mayor, Jean-Marc Ayrault. He issued a paper, the Circulaire Ayrault, advising French public administrations to use open source software. So now, in case you're wondering, all those tiny blue spots are migrations. So these are cities or public services that have migrated. So this is available on OpenStreetMap, on UMap. So I'm looking for people who would be willing to contribute to this map so we know who has migrated. Might be a strength in convincing other organizations to migrate, showing that we are not alone and they won't be alone. Now, why am I here? We finished the migration in Nantes and communicated a lot about this. So I get phone calls or emails from other cities or public administrations willing to migrate. And during the discussion, I often ask them, OK, you're planning to migrate or you have migrated, but do you have plans to contribute? Well, the thing is, many organizations that have migrated or planning to migrate don't contribute or don't have a plan for this. So that's why I'm here today. How can we convince them to contribute? Well, here are a few reasons to contribute. Well, take part in the community, lots of nice people, lots of work to do, it's a nice thing. Give back, give something back to the community by improving the tool documentation whatsoever, and help and give something back to the people who already invested in LibreOffice. That's a good reason too. Help improve the tool, documentation for general interest. Yeah, these are tremendous reasons. Yeah, they're good. But you know, that's not enough. I'm going to introduce you a person you have to convince in an organization in order to be able to contribute. Some say he's eating banknotes for breakfast. Let me introduce you to Finance Guy. Now, what's nice about Finance Guy is that their favorite topic is money. So let's talk a bit about money. LibreOffice migrations have a return on investments. They generate savings, OK? So that's usually the reason why people migrate. There is an instant saving the day you migrate because you don't renew your proprietary software licenses. In Nantes, it's 1.6 million. So this is instant saving when you migrate. And then you have savings over time. Every year in Nantes, we estimate that we are saving 260,000 euros. So every year, we spare that money. So the longer we stay with LibreOffice, the longer a company stays with LibreOffice, the more money they're saving. But LibreOffice has to keep up to pace with competing software, mostly proprietary, through bug fixes, feature improvements whatsoever. And that does not come for free. So now, dedicating a few percent of the savings, time, or people to help improve LibreOffice is likely to increase user adoption, because the more features, the more stable the product is, the more your users are pleased, and the less likely you are to go back to productivity to proprietary software. It helps anchor the solution in your organization, and thus it helps you keep the solution and makes more savings over years. So improve user adoption, protect the migration return on investment, contribute to LibreOffice. That seems to, people seem to understand that better than the other reasons for contribution. It's also a virtuous circle, and that's the strength of open source. Every improvement to the product benefits the entire community. It's benefiting other LibreOffice users, other migrated organizations. So it also anchors their migration. And the more features, the more stable, the better the product is, the more people may use it. And there may be new contributors, and so on. So the various ways to contribute, FileDocs, help translate, write documentation, develop, fund bug fixes, support the Document Foundation, fund feature development. In Nantes, I have asked for a budget to fund bug fixes and fund feature development. So it's like 12% of the yearly savings. Some years I may have more, some years less. So for a regular year, it's around 30,000 euros. It was not difficult to have it, having saying that it's protecting the return on investment. So it will probably work in other situations. Now a brief return on experience, because in the city of Nantes, we have no LibreOffice developers. You know? So we have to do procurement, to go through procurement to get people to do the work for us. Okay? So in France, I don't know for other countries, we have problem with the procurement part because all the standard procurement documents are tailored for proprietary software. And there are things in it like the supplier will not be responsible for bugs in open source software. Okay, I want to have development on open source software. I'm going to test it before it is given to the community. So if there are bugs, I need my supplier to fix them. So you see, we have lots of things to fix in the legal documents before we can even start looking for a supplier. Okay? There are also legal aspects with intellectual property, but I think that's the same for every country. Now about practical considerations. We are no specialists in contributing to LibreOffice. We don't know what the conditions required to contribute code to the community versions are. So we can rely on suppliers for that. But we have to choose those suppliers, and we have to know what to look for in their answers to the call for tenders. As we are no specialists, it's quite complicated to find out if a company is really able to contribute or if it's going to be an awkward situation and maybe not very efficient. Hopefully, I have friends that can look at the commits done by people on LibreOffice so I can know the volume of contribution. That's a clue. But for some suppliers, there may not be many contributions, and as I'm not a specialist, I'm not able to know if they really are able to do the stuff or not. So you see, it's a bit complicated when you want to purchase service around LibreOffice, and the guide would be nice to tell people like us what we have to check with our suppliers to ensure that the money is going to be spent efficiently and that the work is going to be done properly. Now, I did some homework this summer. I tried to estimate the cost of proprietary productivity software in the European Union. That's the figure I found, 100 million euros per year. Quick calculation detail. So I took the number of public servants in the European Union. It's around 27.5 million. Okay, that's a lot. I removed the UK. Sorry, guys. In case you wonder, you add like 10 to 15% to the number of public servants if you had UK. I tried to estimate the number of desktop laptops. It's a quite conservative estimate, okay? I took like 25% because not all public servants are behind the computer. You have people in the field, okay? So that gives around 7 million computer users, meaning around 7 million proprietary software licenses. I took the lowest cost I could find for a paid proprietary software license, so 100 euro. I can tell you we used to pay way more for one single license. So also this is probably a very conservative estimate. Yes. Yeah, it's a very conservative estimate, okay.
Three times.
Yeah, close to that, yeah, sure. So we have to be careful, yeah. Maybe people can do more educated guesses as to how much it costs. So then I estimated the yearly cost, because the license you purchase once and then I use for like 10 years. Well, 10 years is the maximum. 5 years is if you want to keep up to date, you've got to purchase every 5 years. So I cut that in half, divide the price by 7. So that's around 14.3 euro per year per user. Multiply that by the number of workers, and then you have a figure. Now imagine if all that money was spared by European Union, and imagine if only a tiny fraction of this was injected in improving LibreOffice. Thank you.